Hello everyone, welcome back to Physics Online Classes for Class 12 students. Let us continue Chapter 3 Current Electricity. Today we are going to study about the new topic from Chapter 3, that is Kirchhoff's rules. So there are totally two rules here we are going to study, and the some basic terms related to Kirchhoff's rules and why we have to study about Kirchhoff's rules, or what is the use of Kirchhoff rules, that we are going to study in today's session. And this is very important to understand the complex electrical networks. Let us start the class. So before going to study about the two rules, first we have to know why we have to study Kirchhoff rules. Remember, sometimes we have the complex electrical circuits. The electrical circuit consists of resistors and cells in a complicated way. You can observe this circuit diagram. So there are totally 14 resistors. You can observe how many resistors are there here. Totally 14. R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7 and R8, R9, R10, R11, R12. R13, R14. How many resistors are there here? Totally, there are 14 resistors. And also it contains other circuit elements like capacitors. So where is the capacitor? You can observe this is a capacitor, C1. C1 is a capacitor, right? C1, C2, C3. So totally there are how many capacitors? 3 capacitors. Similarly, how many cells are there in the same electrical circuit? E1, E2, this is E3, E4. Totally 4 cells, right? And there is an inductor. Here you can observe this is an inductor, right? This is an inductor. So this circuit contains different circuit elements like resistors, inductor, capacitor, and there are more number of cells. In this complicated way, to analyze this circuit or this electrical circuit, we already studied some formula related to resistors, that you can remember resistors in series and resistors in parallel. We know that resistors connected in series is given by the equation RS equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 and so on. Similarly, when the resistors are connected in parallel, we have the formula RP is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is only for two resistors. We studied these formulae, but these formulae are not sufficient to determine the total current or the total potential difference in this complex circuit. To overcome this problem, we are going to use Kirchhoff rules, right? Yes, why we are using Kirchhoff rules? You can observe sometimes the electrical circuits consist of resistors and cells in a complicated way. The known formulae for the series and parallel combination of resistors, they are not sufficient to determine all the currents and potential differences in the circuit. So, to overcome this difficulty, for the analysis of such electrical circuits, two rules are used and they are known as Kirchhoff rules. How many rules we are using here? We are using two rules, and those two rules we are going to call it as Kirchhoff's rules. Why we have to use Kirchhoff rules? Only to overcome the difficulty or to determine the complex electrical circuits. We are using Kirchhoff rules, right? Now, before going to study about the two rules, first we have to know some basic terms related to Kirchhoff rules. The first point is electrical network. What is electrical network? A combination of various circuit elements and voltage sources. They are called electrical network. What is electrical network? A combination of various circuit elements What do you mean by circuit element? Circuit element means we can use a resistor, capacitor, inductor. These are what? Circuit elements. And also it contains voltage sources. We can use a cell or a battery. These are what? Voltage sources. So these combination we are going to call it as electrical network. Yes, what is electrical network? A combination of various circuit elements and voltage sources. You can observe this electrical circuit. So this electrical circuit contains, it is a combination of various circuit elements. Here in this circuit we have a resistor, capacitor as well as an inductor. It is a combination of various circuit elements and voltage sources. Right? So these are called electrical network. This is an electrical circuit, or we are going to call it as electrical network. Then second point, node and junction. Don't get confused with node and junction. So first we have to know what is a node. A point at which two or more elements are joined together is called node. What is node? A point at which two or more elements are joined together. For example, I am going to consider this is a cell, and here I am going to consider a resistor. Then here I am going to consider a capacitor. Right? Let us take this is a node A. What is node? A point at which two or more circuit elements. Resistor is an element, this is a cell, EMF it is an element, and this is a capacitor. So at point A, how many elements are connected? How many elements are joined? Resistor and cell. This is the cell and this is a resistor. These are joined at this point. So this point we are going to call it as a node. Is what is node? A point at which two or more elements are joined together is called node. You can take this point B. At point B, how many elements are joined here? Two or more than two. Here resistor and capacitors are connected, so we can take it as a node. Right? Then next point, junction. A point where three or more branches meet together is called junction. Yes, what is junction? A point where three or more branches meet together. Here I am going to consider resistor. So this point, let us take this is point D. Now I am going to call this D as a junction. What happens? You can observe at the point D, this is a point where three or more branches. This is the first branch, this is the second branch, and this is the third branch. More than three branches where it is going to meet at the point D, and this is called junction. Don't get confused with node and junction. Node means more than two or more elements are going to join. Junction is a point where three or more branches meet together is called junction. Right? You can observe this diagram. We are going to consider two cells having the potential difference V1 and V2. There are two resistors R1 and R2. One more resistor there here, that is R3. R1, R2, R3. There are three resistors and two cells. Don't get confused with node and junction. Observe the diagram. Where is the node? You can take this is the point A. This is B, C and D. Which are the nodes here? A and C are the nodes. Why A and C are called as nodes? Because at A and at C, how many circuit elements are connected? Two circuit elements, resistor and cell. These two circuit elements, remember, circuit element means the element where we are going to use in a circuit, electrical circuit. For example, resistor, cell, inductor, bulb, capacitor, these are circuit element. How many circuit elements are joined at point A? Two elements. Resistor and cell is joined at point A, so this is called a node. At point C, again resistor and cell are joined, so we are going to call it as a node. Then junction at point B, three branches of the circuit are joined here. Right? Here also at point D, three branches, 1, 2, and 3. Three branches are joined, so we are going to call it as junction. Remember one point, a junction must be a node, but a node may or may not be a junction. Junction is always a node. Junction is equal to node. Both are same here. Junction must be a node because at this node, you can observe three elements are joined, V1, V2, that is a cell. There are two cells and one resistor R3. These three elements are joined at point D. So this is a node. Junction must be a node, but a node may or may not be a junction. Now here at point A, now this is a node. This node may be a junction, may not be a junction. Sometimes node is acting as a junction. Sometimes node is not equal to junction, but junction must be a node. Node and junction both are same. Is it clear? Yes. What is node and junction? A point at which two or more elements are joined together is called node. And what is junction? A point where three or more branches meet together is called junction. Then third term is mesh. Mesh, or we are going to call it as loop. Yes, what is mesh or loop here? A closed path for the current in an electrical network is called a mesh, or we are going to call it as a loop. A closed path for the current in an electrical network is called mesh or loop. You observe this circuit diagram. Here, mesh or loop is what? A closed circuit or a closed path for the current. Here you can observe, I am going to consider this is a cell E. From this cell, I1 amount of current is flowing. I1 amount of current is flowing through the resistor, here also I1. Similarly, the same amount of current is flowing here. This is I1, this is I1, and here also I1. So this is what? The closed path. Let us start with A, B, C, D, A. A, B, C, D, A. This is a closed path, A to A. Right? So the closed path for the current in an electrical network is called mesh, or we are going to call it as loop. Or you can take other branch of the circuit here. This is loop 1. And this is loop 2, right? Either we can measure in anti-clockwise direction or in a clockwise direction. But remember, it should be a closed path. The closed path for the current in an electrical network is called mesh, or we are also going to call it as loop. Is it clear, all the three terms? Electrical network, node and junction, mesh. Mesh, or we are going to call it as loop. What is electrical network? A combination of various circuit elements and voltage sources. What is node? A point at which two or more elements are joined together. What is junction? A point where three or more branches meet together is called junction. And what is mesh or loop? A closed path for the current in an electrical network is called mesh or loop. Yes. Totally, there are two Kirchhoff's rules. How many rules are there? Two rules. The first rule is called junction rule, or we can call it as Kirchhoff's first law or Kirchhoff's current law. In short, we can call it as KCL. What is KCL? Kirchhoff's current law or Kirchhoff's first law, or we can also call it as junction rule. Yes, what is junction? A point where three or more branches meet together, that gives junction. So Kirchhoff's first law or junction rule or Kirchhoff's current law, or in short, we can call it as KCL. Then what it states? It states that at any junction, the sum of the currents entering the junction is equal to the sum of the currents leaving the junction. What is the first law states here? It states that at any junction, sum of the current entering is equal to sum of the current leaving. Remember, how much current is produced by the cell? The same amount of current is passing through the cell. Right? As the total current flowing in is equal to total current flowing out. So that the algebraic sum of the current at a junction must be equal to zero. So the equation is given by summation of I is equal to zero. This is Kirchhoff's first law. Yes, what is the statement? At any junction, the sum of the current entering the junction is equal to sum of the currents leaving the junction. Yes, I will explain here. You can observe this diagram. This is the point P. Let us consider the point P. At this point P, you can observe we are going to consider 6 branches of current. I1, I2, I3, I4, I5 and I6. Carefully you have to observe the directions. Now you can observe I1 is entering the junction P. I2 is also entering. I3 is also entering. I1, I2, I3, these branches of the currents are entering the junction P. Then, what about I4? Here, I4 is leaving the junction. It is going out. It is flowing out. I4 is flowing out. I5 is also flowing out. I6 is also flowing out. It is going out or it is leaving the junction. Right? I1, I2, I3, these are entering the junction, but I4, I5, I6, they are leaving the junction. They are equal. So what is P here? Let us consider P is a junction. I1, I2 and I3, these are the currents entering the junction. I4, I5 and I6 are the currents leaving the junction. That means sum of the current entering the junction is equal to sum of the current leaving the junction. That is, you can observe the equation I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to I4 plus I5 plus I6. Right? So that summation of I is equal to 0. This is Kirchhoff's first law or KCL. What it states? At any junction, sum of the currents entering the junction is equal to sum of the currents leaving the junction. So, summation of I is equal to 0. And note that Kirchhoff's junction rule is in accordance with law of conservation of charge. What is the principle of KCL? The principle of KCL is law of conservation of charge. What it states law of conservation of charge? It states that the total charge in an isolated system remains constant. The total charge in the isolated system remains constant. For example, I am going to consider here I1 amount of current is flowing. Here I2 amount of current is flowing. Now tell me how much current is flowing out. This is the junction. Let us take this is point P. The sum of the current entering the junction, let us consider here 2 ampere current is flowing and here 3 ampere current is flowing. So how much current is flowing out? Totally, that is I1 plus I2, let us take it as 2 plus 3 equal to 5 ampere. That means how much current is entering the junction, the same amount of current is leaving the junction. It is based on the principle of law of conservation of charge. You may get one more question in your board examination or in any competitive examination like what is the principle of KCL or what is the principle of Kirchhoff's first rule or what is the principle of Kirchhoff's junction rule? The answer is the law of conservation of charge. The total charge of the isolated system remains constant. So this is all about the first rule, which is called as Kirchhoff's current rule. Then, now we can study about the second rule. Second rule is called loop rule. or Kirchhoff's second law, or we can also call it as Kirchhoff's voltage law, in short KVL. The first rule is KCL. Now the second rule is KVL. KVL means what? Kirchhoff's voltage law. What it states, you can observe. It states that the algebraic sum of changes in the potential, the algebraic sum of changes in the voltage or changes in the potential around any closed loop involving resistors and cells in the loop is zero. Or we can also state that the algebraic sum of product of current and resistances is equal to algebraic sum of EMFs in that mesh. Mesh means what? Loop. See here, Kirchhoff's second rule states that in simple way we can say that algebraic sum of change in the potential in a closed loop is zero. What it states? The algebraic sum of change in potential around any closed loop is equal to zero. That means the sum of potential. Potential is given by the equation V equal to IR. So here delta V, or we can say that the summation of V is equal to zero. This is the second rule. But you should remember, in any closed loop, only in this closed loop, the total potential or the sum of changes in the potential is zero for the closed loop. Instead of V, we can write IR. Summation of IR is equal to summation of E. E means what here? EMF. So, the algebraic sum of the product of current and resistance is equal to algebraic sum of EMF in that mesh. And the equation is summation of IR is equal to summation of E. Now, I will explain here. First, you have to observe the circuit diagram. Here you can observe totally there are two cells E1 and E2. The cell contains internal resistors R1 and R2. This cell, E1 cell, is connected to external resistor R1. So the current flowing through this resistor is how much? I1. I1 current is flowing. Now here, this is connected to another resistor R3. Then second cell E2, it is connected to external resistor R2. Observe the circuit diagram carefully. We are going to consider two loops here. Right? This is the first loop from E1 to E1. Or we can consider the second loop, that is from E2 to E2. Right? This is a loop, or we can call it as a mesh. See here, from the cell, I1 amount of current is flowing through the resistor R1. I1 amount of current is flowing. Now it reaches the point A. Point A is called junction, where more than three branches are joined here. I1 current is flowing here. And from the cell E2, I2 amount of current is flowing. Here we can get I2, and here the current is I1. Now here at this junction, I1 and I2, these two currents, sum of I1 and I2, that is equal to I3. I3 equal to what? I1 plus I2. These two branches or the current in both the branches are joined at point A. So total current is flowing through I3. I3 equal to I1 plus I2. This I3 current is flowing through the resistor R3. Now at the junction B, according to the first rule, that is KCL, how much current is flowing in, the same amount of current is flowing out. Now here at cell E1, how much current is flowing? I1. At cell E2, I2. Now this I3 is divided as I1 and I2. Applying loop rule to the loop A, B, E1. This is what? E1 means cell 1. A, B, E1, A. Let us start with A. How much current is flowing at this point? through A at this junction, total potential is how much? I3 R3, because we know that V equal to IR. That equation we can use here. How much current is flowing here? I3 R3. Sum of the change in the potential in a closed loop is equal to 0. That statement we can use here. See here, I3 R3, that is I3 R3 plus here at point B, AB, BE1, E1 to A. Right? This loop we have to consider. A to B, what is the potential? I3 R3. B to E1, how much potential is there here? That is, current is I1 from the B. And the resistor is what? Internal resistor, that is R1. I1 R1. Plus, similarly, next, E1 to A, how much potential is there here? I1 R1. So the equation is I3 R3, I1 small R1 plus I1 capital R1. The sum of change in the potential in a closed loop is equal to EMF of that cell, that is E1. So equation 1 you can observe, I3 R3 from the branch AB, I1 R1 this is from the branch BE1, I1 R1 is from E1 to A, AB E1 A, from A to A, this closed loop we have to consider, and this is equal to EMF in that loop. In this loop, which EMF is there here? E1. So this is equal to, on RHS side we can write E1. Similarly, now you can observe the second branch or the second loop we can consider is A, B, E2. This is E2 here, cell E2 to A. This branch we can consider A, B, E2, A. Now tell me, from the branch AB, what is the potential? I3, R3. Right? Here it is I3, R3. From the branch B to E2, B to E2. That is I2, small R2. From the branch E2 to A, E2 to A, that is I2, R2. Sum of these value, I3, R3 plus I2, R2 plus I2, capital R2. This is equal to EMF in that mesh. EMF in that mesh is E2. Let us take it as equation number 2. We applied loop rule to the loops AB E1A and AB E2A. From equation 1 and 2, we can observe sum of the product of electric current and resistor is equal to sum of, or the algebraic sum of, EMF in that shell. Summation of IR is equal to summation of E. Is it clear? What is the statement of Kirchhoff's second law? It states that the algebraic sum of change in potential around any closed loop is equal to 0. Or we can also state that the algebraic sum of product of current and resistor is equal to algebraic sum of EMF in that mesh. And remember Kirchhoff loop rule or the second law. It is in accordance with the law of conservation of energy. What is the statement of law of conservation of energy? Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but one form of energy can be converted into another form. So this is the principle of KVL. KVL means what? Kirchhoff's voltage rule. Kirchhoff voltage rule is based on the principle of law of conservation of energy. KCL, that is Kirchhoff current law. Kirchhoff current law is based on the principle of law of conservation of charge. These two Kirchhoff rules are very important to determine or to analyze the complex electrical circuits containing different circuit elements like resistors, inductors, capacitors, bulb, cells, battery. So if the circuit is in a complicated way, then using these Kirchhoff rule, we can make it easy to determine the total current or the total potential difference in that circuit.